sir. Yeah. Tell me what democracy looks like.
This is what democracy looks like.
Tell me what democracy looks like.
This is what democracy looks like.
Tell me what democracy looks like.
This is what democracy looks like.
Sure, this is what democracy looks like, guys.
Sadie.
I have been doubting about that. And I have been having my serious doubt because we sat here in 2016 and we argued. We argued among us, we decided not to go to vote. And then we woke up and Trump was president.
That ain't right.
Because we could not believe that something like that could have happened. Because we Americans are too good. We know what it is, right? We know how we do things. And instead of actually ensuring that what we didn't want happened, we sat and let what we did not want to happen. Then we woke up and we cried. And we upset. And we have been marching since then. The Women's March, the Gun Reform March, everybody has been out in the street and fussing since then. We're playing catch up. We're playing catch up against somebody who actually went on hate. He told us exactly what he was going to do. He sat here and called my friend from Mexico rapist.
Ain't right.
And we sat there and was like, oh no, he was never done anything. He said that he was going to shut the Muslim out down. We like, oh no, maybe right. Because he's a Muslim, a terrorist, right? Then the Muslim ban happened. But now, he's taking everybody's rights away. Our rights are at risk. It's not only the Muslims. It's not only the Mexicans. It's not only the Liberians. It's not only the people of Honduras. Because as we sit here today, we have sit and watch all the TPS, DACA, different countries, DED, being shut down. And some of us did not even pick up a phone and call the representative. She said, call the representative. But you should be doing it now. You should have done it yesterday. Have them come speak up. Not only calling them, but show up in their office. If they don't, I'm not here in Michigan, tell them to do so. So that what you are upset about, what you are frustrated about, they are able to understand that we need business. Because we sit here, we are to get upset. Thousands and thousands and thousands of children are being taken away at the border. Right? But our rights are at least within the border. Because within the border, we have 150% ways of deportation for family being separated right here in Michigan. It happens every day. At the ICE office right next door, I come here on a weekly basis and drop luggages of parents being taken away. On a weekly basis, I come here and bring luggage because there is a father being taken away, there is a mom being taken away, there is an aunt being taken away, there is an object being taken away. It's happened on a weekly basis in our communities. We don't need to wait till thousands of children are being ripped apart for us to get up and say enough is enough.
Yeah!
We're talking about trauma. We have children. I'm a social worker. I know what this feels like when you have to go to somebody's house and say, hey, I have to take your child because you don't take care of them. Right? We have thousands of families here going through the foster care system and we don't like the foster care system because the foster care system means abuse and trauma. But they will allow that to happen to other children because they have color. Because let's face it, they have a tint. And their tint might be brown, their tint might be chocolate, their tint might be like mine. And it's okay when it happens to families like us. And that's the reality that we have to face. Because unless we understand that what we're doing is racial justice, that what we are facing right now is structural racism, and we are really doing the way of structural racism, we are not going to the brunt of this. So we are all responsible. In Michigan, here in Detroit, we have 14,000 African immigrant families. And every week, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 fathers are being taken away out of this community right here.
Right.
2 weeks ago, we rallied, we cried, but my friend Kathy was taken away after spending 29 years in this country. His children was born here, the oldest one is 16, the youngest one is 3. And now we are left trying to figure out what we're going to do with them. And as we cry about that, I have another family where the father and the mother are called together at the same time, every 3 weeks. So every 3 weeks they leave their children, the oldest one is 16, and she had to sit and wonder if her parents are gonna show up or not. And this is why today we're here to say that enough is enough. And I hope that we're not gonna only hug, we are not only gonna walk, that we are really gonna decide to stay in the fight, get in the mud and stay in the mud. We don't have to wait till somebody else that looks like a child and take them away. I hope that when we come out from here, each of us is going to reach out to a group, to a family, and actually commit to do the work from now on until we get this person out of there. 2018 is coming. We are in 2018. Elections are around the corner. Don't stay at home. Drive your neighbors that don't know how to drive. Go pick them up and take them to the poll and make sure that you get people in there that you know you can hold accountable.
Yep.
If we do not fix what we created, we are going to be responsible. Because the history is going to be here when these children right here going to have to ask us what we will do and what kind of society we are living for them to fix. Yep. And I don't think that it's right to bring it in this world and then create the mess and leave it for them to fix. So thank you guys for being here. I hope that we are going to stay engaged and remain engaged and do the right thing and fix, you know, amend the wrong that we have done while we sat here and let them take it. Thank you.
Oh.